So this is continuation of lecture number 23, and in this particular part of the lecture I will be discussing about the system components and the various terminologies that are associated with wind turbines. So these are the following components, which include the tower, rotor, the shaft, electrical generator, the yaw mechanism, sensors and the control systems, eddy current or the other brakes to hold the turbine, the anemometers, the stall controller, the battery and the transmission link. The tower is basically used to elevate the windmill for the certain reasons that we have discussed in the previous part of the lecture. The second one is the rotor. The rotor connects the generator either directly or indirectly through a shaft and a series of gears that speed up the rotation and allow a physically smaller generator size. Then there is the main shaft. It is a piece of metal from a tube which constitutes the most important spinning parts, since it conveys the energy from the wind turbine blades to the other parts of the wind turbine. The electrical generator, the wind turbine generator is what makes the actual electricity by converting the mechanical energy of the wind into electrical energy. The yaw mechanism or the yaw drive is an important component of the horizontal axis wind turbines. The yaw mechanism is used to ensure the wind turbine is producing maximum amount of electric energy at all the times. The yaw drive is used to keep the rotor facing into the wind direction, as the wind direction is continuously changing. So basically it is used as a wind tracker. Next are the sensors and the control system. We can control the turbine by controlling the generator speed, the blade angle, the adjustment and the rotation of the entire windmill. Blade angle adjustment and turbine rotation are also known as pitch and the yaw control. Two types of generator control include the stator and the rotor control. The next one is the eddy current or other brakes to hold the turbine so that wind can brakes can be applied when we want to let's say slow the turbine if the wind speeds are relatively very high, so that the system is saved from being damaged. Then there are anemometers. They are used to measure the wind speeds and transmit its data to the control towers. Then there is a stall control mechanism, and then there are batteries, the standalone parts in order to store the excess amount of power that is being generated by the windmill, so that we can use it when there is no supply of wind. Then there is a transmission link for the connection to the grid. So these are the commonly used terminologies. The rotor is a two or three blades attached to a hub. We have discussed its various designs, and we have also observed that various designs have different efficiencies, with the most effective ones were the two high speed two blade and the universal the most recent technologies of three blade rotor technologies. Then there is hub, that is the mounting point for the rotor blades. Then there is a gearbox, that is a mechanical subsystem for the transforming a low speed input, let's say 30 to 60 revolutions per minute, to a high speed output using a gear mechanism. Then there is the low speed shaft between the rotor and the gearbox. It is basically used as a connector. Then there is a high shear speed shaft, which is used to connect the gearbox and the generator. There is a generator with variable speed induction generator, which produces regular power with alternating currents of frequency of 50 to 60 hertz, so that they can be used to derive over regular appliances. Then there is nickel, That is the announcement of the gearbox, shaft, brakes, and generator. It is basically a enhancement to encase all these things. Then there is pitch, the alignment of blades with respect to wind direction. Blades pitch out of wind at very low or high speeds to control the pitch movements. Then there is a yaw drive, then that motor drive to keep the upwind turbine facing into the wind and not required for the downwind turbines.